Well, it's just been announced that the remains of iconic bushranger Ned Kelly have finally been identified 130 years after he was hanged. The discovery comes after an extensive 20-month search through historical and genetic records. Our reporter David Woywood joins us now with all the details from Melbourne. Extraordinary news, David. How was this discovery made?
Well, morning, Tash. Yes, it is huge news. The forensic teams here have formally identified the remains of missing bushranger Ned Kelly. Now, it had long been thought that Ned Kelly's remains had been buried somewhere under the old Melbourne jail, but that was always only the subject of rumour. But these teams have been working hard, forensically examining parts of the old bushranger, and they have confirmed that, yes, his remains are here in Melbourne. Now, the examination began around 2 years ago when Ned Kelly's skull had been returned. It was stolen in the 1970s, and when it was returned in 2009, they were able to use that skull as well as DNA from one of Ned Kelly's relatives. Now, this is where it gets a bit confusing. It's Ned Kelly's sister's great-grandson taking his DNA, and he's a Melbourne school teacher. They were able to piece together exactly where Ned Kelly was. Now, the announcement's just been made a few seconds ago, and this is exactly what they had to say.
The saga of Ned Kelly has fascinated Victorians for over a century. Among all the historical figures in our state's history, Kelly is unique in his ability to generate debate and to polarise opinion. To many, he was and remains a romantic figure who defied unjust authority.
Well, as you've heard there, there's still some debate about exactly what will happen now to Ned Kelly's body. Obviously, some see him as a cold-blooded cop killer and others see him as some part of the romantic Australian folklore. But the Attorney General hasn't exactly said what will happen, but I'm sure there'll be a lot of people that will be lining up to see Ned Kelly's remains.
Absolutely. Thank you for the update. David Woywood joining us there with all the details from Melbourne.